do this. Rubbish already.
Thank you. Stop! Please! Don't shoot. If you want the encryption cipher, you're welcome to it. There's no need for all this violence. No. No catch. I'm not trying to trick you. You want the cipher? It's yours. At this point, I'd do anything to get back at my brother. He deserves everything he's got coming to him. You're kidding, right? My brother is Benjamin Bayou. The one and only. He's the administrator of Neon. And the reason I'm so damn miserable. I think you could safely say that most of Neon would agree. You know, I've spent my entire life living in Ben's shadow. Everything always works out for him. While I've been bouncing from one job to the next, barely keeping afloat. And all the while, he laughs at me behind my back. Thinks it's hilarious to make fun of his stupid brother. Like I wouldn't eventually find out.
Tyrants like your brother eventually fall. It's inevitable. Perhaps you should just give it some time.
One advantage to being perceived as stupid is that no one takes you seriously. When I walk into a party, I'm instantly the resident social pariah. But my eyes and ears are wide open. I can't tell you the number of times I've overheard that my brother has spread amusing anecdotes about his stupid brother. That wouldn't do any good. For every scheme he's gotten himself into, he has a bulletproof exit strategy. Man's virtually immortal.
Ugh, that's true. He's a slippery man who can worm his way out of any legal situation.
You know what? I am sick to death of being pushed around. It's my turn to take control for once. The passcode for my terminal is GEN-41A18. That should give you access to the cipher and whatever else you need. I'm getting out of here while I still can. After you're done, I suggest you do the same. Because he's a two-faced son of a bitch, that's why. It's not like I should be surprised. When we were younger, we never got along very well. I mean, he's 11 years older than I am. We had two different mothers. As well have been from two separate families. That's an understatement. I never knew my actual mother. She was my father's mistress. And I was told she vanished from Neon when I was only 2 years old. Ben's mother, she didn't give a crap about me. Wouldn't even let me call her mom. I just had to call her Liliana. Can you imagine? And then there's Dad. So buried in the day-to-day operations of Neon, he didn't have time to pay attention to his bastard son. Yeah, I've tried, but I always hit a dead end. It's as though she was here one day and suddenly vanished the next. And then her existence was erased from everyone's memory. I wouldn't be at all surprised if my father had her killed to avoid public embarrassment. That's the kind of man he was. Yeah, maybe. Or he could just be a first-class asshole who takes after our father. Look, I appreciate what you're trying to do, and it's nice to get this off my chest, but talking about it isn't gonna change a thing. That's why I gave you the encryption cipher. Anything I can do to stick it to Ben, that's the real therapy. On a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being the worst, I'm at about, I don't know, a negative 8? I don't have the background for this electrical engineering stuff. Chief technician? It's ridiculous. Ben stuck me down here, expecting me to work miracles. He didn't stop for even a second to think of the repercussions. That's so typical. All I need is one breakthrough. One! And I could shove this job right in his face. Damn, that would feel good. Holy crap. You might be right. I mean, it would take some time, but I bet I could figure it out. Huh. All this time I've been trying to develop something new, and it's been staring me in the face for years. Oh man, that is so like me. Thank you for giving me that kick in the ass I needed to get going. As usual, you can thank my dear brother for that. At first, he made me deputy administrator. That went well, until I wouldn't cooperate with Owen Dexler and all of his thugs at Neon Security. Then, he had me work with Valentina over at Xenofresh, helping with Aurora distribution. Until she pinned the credit-skimming scam on me. And now, here I am, chief technician at Genardyne. And I don't even know the first thing about electrical engineering. Thanks again for the talk. It really helped.
Okay, that's it. Time to sell some of your junk.
to officially switch to water.
Gotta stay hydrated, right?
You said it. Plus, I have to meet up with...
This place is insane!
You are. What kept you? I believe we have a lot to discuss. It's obvious you're here to meet someone. Fortunately for them, they rented this VIP room under a false name. I assume that same someone provided you with that clever little virus you installed into Genardyne's systems. All too well. You know, I should give credit where it's due. That virus is quite impressive. It will cost me tens of thousands of credits to remove. That's the last time I'll ever take the Crimson Fleet's capabilities for granted. And I'm a businessman, which means I know when to walk away from a deal. You want to know why? It's because I don't negotiate with pirates. They don't understand commitments or contracts, how to get the deal done with finesse. No, for your kind, it's only brute force and violence. Shoot first, take whatever you want, and ask questions later. That's not how I do business. There. You see, all you know how to do is threaten violence. Exactly my point. Look, I'm not here to debate. I'm here to make an offer. All you have to do is tell me who's profiting from the virus you've uploaded. In return, I'll let you leave the city alive.
You make my skin crawl, Bayou.
Really? That's the story you're going with. Very well. There's a body that Neon Security is going to be discovering very soon. One with concrete evidence that links you to the murder. I'd say you have about 1 hour to leave this place before you have a price on your head.
You'd have someone killed to pin the crime on us. Oh, you're a wretched excuse for a human being, Bayou.
So, I assume this concludes our little arrangement, and you'll be leaving our fair city. Oh, when you get back to the Key, be certain to give Neva and Delgado my warmest regards.
Interested in. Sidonia is an industrial town. The people there tend to be concise. Talk to you later.
Clover over at Kiltcorp? She's too good for Neon. Sounds like she's trying to help someone or something. Honestly, kind of tuned her out.
Things have gotten pretty bad in Epside lately.
That's nothing new. Place is a dump.
Maybe we should set up more posts in the area.
Why bother?
I've heard that Benjamin Bayou has a private penthouse at the top of the tower. If Benjamin Bayou's ego was as combustible as Helium 3, he'd be able to provide enough fuel to power every ship in the settled systems.
Seems like the Crimson Fleet is everywhere.
You can take Reliant Edible wherever you go.
Ebside's a bad place for tourists these days.
What?
I wasn't doing anything.
Love your fit. It may not work for some, but you wear it like a champ.
What are you looking at? This? This is Ebside Striker's turf.
Only the upstairs. Don't bother my customers.
Fine, upstairs. That's gang territory, got it? This is what's missing these days. This. It's called respect. Yeah, you used to be people were afraid of the Strikers. We had a name, got it? Now the Disciples got us penned up in this lousy bar.
Andrea!
Fine, fine, fine. This beautiful establishment. Do you have anything else, or are we done with this? Whatever this is. So you stroll in here and want to meet with Briggs? The nerve. Maybe you should meet with the business end of my shiv, huh, tourist?
No blood in my shop, Andrea. I'm this close to tossing the lot of you out on the street.
Fine, fine already. You're lucky. Only way you see Briggs is if you, want to join the Ebside Strikers. You know where to find me.
No customer. Bienvenue. Before you order, I have two simple rules you need to know. Oh, this is my place. That means everyone in here is under my protection. You don't mess with them, they don't mess with you. If you're buying drinks, you better have cash. Madame Sauvage does not offer credit. A tout à l'heure.
Excuse me. It's a mood.
No customer. Bienvenue. Oh. If you'll buy. Oh, well. Thank you very much for the compliment. I'm told my family tree traces itself back to Europe, on Earth. Specifically, the region known as France. A long and proud history, no? Finally, someone who listens and does what they're told. A rare commodity in Ebside. I like you already.
I can personally vouch for my colleague here and make sure that he behaves.
So, what can Madame Sauvage get you? Have you come to try velocity, perhaps? Or do you prefer something with a little less kick? Do you want information? Go read a book. You want a drink? Talk to Madame Sauvage. That's how things work in my place. Of course, any... You got a look of neon on you. I can tell. But don't let the other rats hear you complain about your lot in life. Likely you'll get a bitter shiv in the belly for that. Precious few managed to escape. Either you're lucky as hell, or there's something special about you. You do things to survive in the gutter. Every now and then, the good bits. A shared meal, a kind gesture. But most of what you do to survive... Well... There's a reason why liquor flows like water on this ring. Looks like you've already done the hard part. You're free of this place. It gives an old gal hope. In time, I doubt anybody would guess in a million years you came from the streets.
Pardon? Do you have room for one more on your crew? Trust me, you'd be getting a bargain. Why is that?
I hear ya.
One.
You don't know what you're talking about.
Come on, any cheaper and we're bored. Where do you want me? No problem, Captain.
Yeah?
Love the vibe in this city.
Nothing like a Velocity after a rough shift at Xeno. Makes you forget how bad you stink.
I'm zoned out of my mind right now.
Can I get you something? On my home planet, we have beautiful beaches. And during... Now, I think it's at that. That is the essence. We'll see you again soon, yes?
Strikers may be better, but we ain't beaten yet. We were one of the big dogs. We could take what we want. And Briggs? Told. I mean, the Strikers will rob you blind, and if you back us in a corner, you're gonna bleed. But the Disciples? Total nutjob animals. They torture people for kicks. And the only people that kept them from getting out of control? Us. And now we're all but ruined. We were one of the big and Briggs told. So you stroll in here. Maybe you should meet with the business end of my.
No blood in.
Fine already. You know, I'll just do that. Right now. This ought to be good. Sure, let's go meet the boss.
Okay. Hello. I don't know what you think you heard, but maybe you should get your hearing checked.
Someone says they might want to join.
A recruit?
Been a while.
I know, right? Savage says we can't go killing people around here anymore.
We shouldn't be doing that anyhow. You want to join us? We're a gang. You understand that, right? Not some daring adventure bullshit you can brag to your friends about. We steal, we mug, we kill if we have to. People that come to us have usually run out of options. So are you really interested? There was a time when we were the only ones that kept those psychos in line, but I'll get to that. Let me tell you about us. What makes the Strikers different is we're family. It's us against every goddamn thing the world can throw at us. If you're in, we'll go through hell and back for you.
It's been a little too much of that hell going round.
Vogel, not the time. We do everything we can to make sure everyone's got a roof overhead and fish in their belly. I prefer we fleece the marks, not kill them. Better for everyone in the long run. But you do what you gotta do. Ebside is where all the loser and sad stories end up. Once Neon and Administrator Bayou has used them up. Surviving here ain't easy. Sometimes blood's got to flow just to get food based on your plate. But we only take what we have to. Not so fast. I gotta get to know you first. What would you bring to the Strikers? Now you are speaking my language. Good. I'm not sure what your game is. But if you really want to join, there's a test. You're going up against the Disciples. Everyone in Ebside's been chewed up and ground up by Neon. Some people snap, and snap hard. The Disciples are maniacs, pure and simple. The test is to find out who has been arming those nutjobs with military-grade hardware. We're fully in alignment there.
I can't understand this sudden urge to join the Strikers gang. I can think of about 100 better ways you could be spending your time.
There's a warehouse they use. One of our friends said there's a slate there that has the info we need.
Well, that's my job. I was going to go in and make them pay.
You want it? Too bad, Vogel. You go in there, and it's a bloodbath. I want someone that can snatch it from them. Ideally with them never even knowing it happened. Consider this your audition. Try not to get killed, new fish.
Don't break a leg! because it's an audition. Whatever.
The job's about getting the slate. Focus on that. Good?
Pull up a chair and have a drink.
Thank you.
wonder where this will all lead. Until later. I have things for you. Been a long time since I've been to Mars. Sol system doesn't get a lot of traffic. Yep, here you go. Bye for now. They're not going to need it anymore.
Ha! I knew it!
Thank you.
Hopefully, this is the way forward. I wonder what we'll stumble across next. Is this a way out of here?
Can I help you? You lost, kiddo? Yeah, well, make it quick. I ain't a fan of loitering. I had some high hopes for this shop back when my husband and I opened it a while back. These days, we'll see about that. Solomon thought a small convenience store with cheaper prices would make a killing. Of course, the only killing made was when he got himself shot in a robbery. Now it's just me running this place, so you can see why I'm not a huge fan of strangers in my shop. Mostly tied up in those good-for-nothing gangs. Those disciples and strikers always fighting over who gets to run the place, and not giving a damn over whose lives they ruin. I may not be on the main strip, but I make enough to keep me afloat. Lucky for me, my regulars are a devoted crew. Just the usual. See you around.
Days are too short. Life's too long. You're bothering me.
Then you should stop. I work the warehouses. Clock in, clock out, mind my business. Gangs leave me alone. You should too. It's one of my rules, and it served me well. Besides, fact is, I'm not a good man. Best keep your distance. No, I'm not. Not particularly. Yeah, I bet you do. Yeah, keep things short. Don't drink on the job, drink every minute after. Never play cards with a street rat. Don't love what you can't respect. That's all I got. Anything more would break the first rule. Uh-huh.
Security, you're under arrest. You know, I can just tell you've got no contraband. Let's head to the station, though.
Stop immediately! Stop running!
Freeze! Neon security!
Good. We don't need any more trouble today.
me I have to take my entire load of alcohol back to New Atlantis?
Security's got its eyes on Saburo Okadipo. That guy's trouble for the status quo, if you know what I mean.
The hardest part is showing up.
Glad you're back. Sorry about the whole Benjamin Bayou thing at the Astral Lounge, but I didn't have much of a choice. Can you believe the nerve of that smug son of a bitch? The man is priceless. Well, I was hoping we'd celebrate your return with some drinks and a pile of Aurora. I was about to start partying early when Boone Morgan tipped me off that Bayou was on his way down with some Neon security goons. I'm pretty sure I missed him by less than a minute. Left a ton of good stuff behind, damn it. So I've heard. Throwing yourself under the bus like that. Ouch. You are one crazy son of a bitch. Yeah, I'm pretty much dead in the water at this point. Since Bayou flagged the virus, I can't risk accessing the system now. All that work I did trying to crack Jenardyne is gone. Now I'm in a bit of a bind. The prep work for this job put me in deep for a bunch of cash, and I have no way to pay it all back. Well, a business partner of mine named Nix was the author of the virus. Don't know if you know him or not. Then there's the folks I paid to keep an eye on Ayumi Komiko, a few of the guards at Jenardyne. Like I said, it was a huge job. Honestly, I shouldn't be revealing my sources because that puts you on their radar as well. But hey, you asked. That's exactly what I had in mind. I guess you aren't such a rook after all. How much are you willing to part with? Well, it's a bit less than I was hoping for, but thanks all the same. At least you gave a crap enough to cut me in at all.
That was a bit less than I was expecting as well, but at least you've gained something for your efforts.
All right, I guess we're done here. Tell Delgado if he ever needs me for anything else. I've still got his back. And hey, you won't be hearing Rook from me anymore. As far as I'm concerned, you're one of us now. Lifeblood of the fleet. If anyone tries to tell you otherwise, you send them to talk to me. I hear things are heating up back at the quay, so I might fire up my bird and head over to check things out. Rumor has it that Delgado has some solid info on the Crix's legacy story he's been hawking for the last few years. If there's even a chance that it's true, I want to be there when Shinya Voss starts splitting the loot, if you catch my meaning. Completely ruined?
Nah.
I was hoping it would stay on Generdyne's mainframe for the long term, but hey, at least it's already fed me a huge amount of data. Nix really knows what he's doing, though he charged me about 6 months worth of earnings. With any luck, I'll be able to recoup my costs in no time. Now, how did I know you were gonna ask me that? Honestly, doesn't matter if I believe that Crix's legacy exists or not. What's important is that I believe in Delgado. If the man thinks that chasing shadows is gonna make us rich, then who the hell am I to judge, right? I mean, I'm not gonna jump off a cliff for him or anything, but hey, he needs an extra ship at his side, he's got it. Put in a good word to Delgado for me, will ya?
Maybe you'd like to try a velocity.
Cliff dive today.
Once considered ineffective, even a potential ally in combating some of the settled
troops
is a dangerous threat.
I'm not.
For you.
All is well, Captain, all things considered.
Sidonia is an industrial town. The people there tend...
I certainly do. It's all yours.
Okay.
Everything's 5x5, Captain. Aye, Captain. Good to see you.
You... How do you think this adventure is going? Of course! I'm always happy to help. part of your crew is just the best.
Everything looks good at my station, Captain.
While we're here, perhaps we should remain silent about my background with the United Colonies.
All hell's breaking loose, Rook. Delgado needs you in the repair bay with Jazz as soon as possible. Oh, that's hilarious. You're a real comedian, you know that? Now get your ass to the repair bay. Go!
I don't trust you.
I got secret compartments on my ship just in case.
Sure we will have those defense batteries up and running?
No. I'm not sure. They're in bad shape, Del. Really bad shape. I'm already using duct tape and spit to keep the station from falling apart, and you want me to pull a rabbit out of my hat?
I don't want to hear excuses. I want to hear that it's going to be fixed. Period. Get it done.
All right. I'm on it.
You want to quit standing there and hand over the conduction grid data?
Nothing you need to worry about.
Stay in your own space lane and let Jazz do her damn job. Now, do you have what we sent you to Neon for, or not?
Wow. Really?
You know what else isn't easy? Listening to complaints and excuses. From everyone.
All right, I get it. Just hand over the tech.
All right, listen up, because I don't want to repeat this twice. We've gotten word that UC SysDef is massing somewhere nearby for an attack on the key. While we prepare for their arrival, I want you to head straight for Bannock 4 and bring Crixus' legacy home. No. I need you to stay the course and bring that money back to the fleet. Lay it out, Jess.
All right, first things first. I'm gonna upload this data you snagged from Genardyne into the Keys databanks. All you need to do is build and then install a conduction grid module onto your ship. Oh, and if you haven't already, you'll need the comm spike module installed as well.
While we're at it, perhaps we should fetch your groceries for you as well?
Once your ship is ready, jump out to Bannock 4, board the Legacy, and bring us the cash. Everything you'll need for ship repair and construction is down in Jess's section of the key. If you have any questions about the modules, she'll have all the answers. Of course there's a catch. What, you thought this would be easy?
After you board the Legacy, be on the lookout for two transfer modules. They're special keys that allow access to the ship's vault. Once you locate the vault's control center, hook up the data core I'm gonna give you, and download everything they've got.
And before you get any bright ideas, like running off with the money, that currency is going to be heavily encrypted. Only a genius like Shinya will be able to crack that encryption. So bring it back here right away. That would be a first. I have yet to see encrypted currency that Shinya could not manipulate within hours. I mean, the guy plugs his body directly into his mainframe. He eats, breathes, and shits numbers all day. No, I'm not worried about him. Yeah? I sure hope so. Look, I'm gonna make this real simple for you. If that money ends up anywhere but the key, I will hunt you down and pry it out of your dead hands myself. Now get moving. The toughest nut to crack is if UC SysDef brings in the Vigilance. That Commander Ikande has himself a hell of a ship there. Advanced shield tech, bristling with weapons. I would love to see that thing burn. If we hope to stand a chance against it, we need those defensive batteries and Krix's legacy. The Crimson Fleet isn't really a fleet. It's an ideal, a principle that Krix sought to set up so that pirates didn't infight over scraps. Over time, that notion has been lost. Captains have been turning their backs on the fleet, doing jobs on the side, killing each other. Bringing Krix's legacy back to the fleet would be like validating everything Jasper Krix believed in. And I'm certain it would unify us once again. Of course, it wouldn't exactly hurt to have all that extra money at our disposal. But I think you catch my meaning. You've met some of them already. Mathis Castillo, Yevgeny Rokov, Juan Dayu, Estelle Vincent, and Adler Kemp. They might feel like independents to you, but each one of them has a stake in the Crimson Fleet, and each one of them wants a cut of the wealth. I am sending word out to every able-bodied captain that they are needed. We'll see how many answer the call. Get moving before it's too late.